In other news in the West Bank, Palestinian violence is also now extending again towards the LGBTQ plus community, as the PA police on Saturday just banned the Al-Qaws Palestinian LGBT rights group from organizing. And in fact, according to the police's statement, PA officers are threatening to arrest Al-Qaws members for planning activities that, quote, go against and infringe upon the higher principles and values of Palestinian society, end quote. Further, police spokesperson Loué Arzekat called on the Palestinian public to report on any Al-Qaws activity to help charge the supposed suspicious parties for sowing discord into society. While in response, the Al-Qaws NGO called the police statement very unfortunate and challenged the PA to learn more about its humanitarian efforts. Al-Qaws says that it's at the forefront of vibrant Palestinian cultural and social change, building LGBTQ communities and promoting new ideas about the role of gender and sexual diversity in political activism, civil society institutions, media, and everyday life. To that end, the organization, founded in 2001 with offices in Haifa and East Jerusalem, was also planning a two-day workshop for late August, the point of which was to supposedly provide a safe space for gay, lesbian, bi, and transgender Palestinian youths to meet, learn basic concepts, and explore the different aspects of human sexuality. That said, the organization also calls against Israel for pinkwashing by saying that Israel's occupation somehow supports the patriarchal and homophobic systems in place in the PA. It's also worth noting, though, that the PA police's ban comes only after Al-Qaws began organizing its August workshop in the PA. Further, Israel does indeed support one of the world's largest gay pride parades annually, drawing over 250,000 people to Tel Aviv just earlier this year. And the city has also been rated as one of the best or most gay-friendly cities on Earth by multiple sources. The major problems here, then, do arise societally, as there are no laws in the Palestinian Authority against homosexual acts. Rather, societal and familial pressures at times become deadly. And that's why, among others, Ahmad Harb, the Commissioner General of the Independent Commission for Human Rights, called on the PA police to rescind its policy. Harb even wrote on Facebook that the police's statement rises to the level of calling for community violence and inciting a crime. Al-Qaws, for its part, however, has already vowed to continue in its mission in the safest way possible.